Hello everyone and welcome to lecture number 10. In the last lecture or in the previous lecture, we have discussed about the isolators. Okay, and if we have a microwave waveguide, this is the input and this is the output. If we want to stop the reflection, okay, if we have this kind of reflection that is coming out, and if you want to stop this reflection, then we can use in between these isolators. Okay, these isolators can be used in between to stop the reflection. Okay, this is the isolator place which can be used. Okay, so isolators are used to stop the reflections, and it will try to improve the matching in between the two devices, microwave devices. Okay, now in today's lecture we are going to study circulators. We are going to study circulators. Okay, we are going to study circulators. Now, what are circulators? Circulators are actually four-pole devices. Okay, circulators are nothing but four-pole devices. Each port is connected just to the next adjacent port. Okay, so if we see the schematic diagram of circulator, then we will have this kind of circle, we will have four ports, we will have four different ports over here. This is just a schematic diagram to understand it. Okay, this is port 1, this is port 2, this is port 3, and this is port 4. Okay, now what happens that the signal moves in this direction. Okay, signal moves in this direction. Now, port 1 is only connected to port 2. Okay, port 1 is only connected to port 2. Port 2 is only connected to port 3. Port 3 is only connected to port 4. And port 4 is only connected to port 1. Remember, port 1 is only connected to this port is only connected to port 2. Port 2 is only connected to port 3. Okay? Then port 3 is only connected to port 4, and port 4 is only connected to port 1. Okay? Remember, each port is only connected to its adjacent ports. Okay, this is nothing but the circulators. These are nothing but circulators. They are number of times you will having a situation where you have just a single transmission line, or in that you may be used, you may be having a usefulness of the transmission or receiving part, or the impedance matching part, or an input circuitry. Over there you can use the circulators. We will see an application with respect to circulators. Okay, so this is a schematic of circulator. Practical diagram of circulator will be something like isolator, but it will have two more ports. Let us see the practical of it. Okay, so this is the simple four port circulators. Each port is being connected to its adjacent port. Okay, now this is the four-port circulator practical diagram that what it will be. This is, you can see over here, you will have port 1, you will have port 1, you will have port 2 over here, you will have port 3 over here, and you will have port 4 over here. Okay, port 4 over here. Now remember, this is TE mode, okay, transverse electric mode. Okay, TE10 mode, that is transverse electric mode, and you have a rectangular to circular transmission. Okay, rectangular to circular Okay, you have rectangular waveguide to circular waveguide connection in between that, and due to that you will be having a 45 degree shift. Okay, you will be having a 45 degree shift over here. Okay, you will be having a 45 degree shift over here, and you may be know that port 1 is only connected to port 2. Okay, port 2 is only connected to port 3. Port 3 is only connected to port 4, and port 4 is only connected to port 1. Port 4 is only connected to port 1. Okay? When you have a rectangular waveguide and you convert it to circular waveguide, this is the rectangular to circular. Okay? This is the rectangular to circular waveguide over here. This part is the joining part of the rectangular to circular waveguide. Over there you will be having a 45 degree shift. Due to the 45 degree shift, signal electric fields will not be able to pass out through this port 3. So input from port 1 will not come out of port 3. Ahead, due to this ferrite rod, the signal will have another 45 degree shift. Another 45 degree shift. 45 degree shift over here. 45 degree shift over here. Another 45 degree shift over here. So, due to another 45 degree shift over here, port 4 will also be not connected to that electric field. And electric field or the transverse electric field will directly pass to port 2. This is the relation between port 1 and port 2. How port 3 and port 4 have been bifurcated, have been detached due to field from 1 to 2. Similarly, when you have port 2 as input, it will have 45 degree shift and 45 degree shift due to port 4, and that is been connected to port 3. That is why it is going to have output at port 3 in such a way that electric field will be able to come out of port 3. Electric field from port 2 will be able to come out of port 3. It will not be able to come out of port 1 or 4. In the same way, signal inserted in port 3 will come out of port 4, and signal inserted in port 4 will be coming out of port 1. Okay, in the same fashion. Now, let us see one of the example of it. Okay, one of the application maybe we will have another circle. We can have this kind of transmission. Okay, we will have this kind of loop, and over here we are having an antenna. Okay, this is antenna. Okay, this is antenna, that is port 2. This will be port 3, that is you can say that it's a radar. A similar kind of phase you will be having. This is a receiving, this is receiver. Similarly, you will be having transmitter. Transmitter will transmit the signal. Again, you will be having a radar over here. Okay, we have taken an example of radar, and over here we will be having an matching network, or we can say that matched termination, matching network. Okay, matching network is there. Now, you can see that transmitter is only connected to antenna. Okay, this is port 1, this is port 2, this is port 3, and this is port 4. Transmitter is only connected to antenna. Antenna is only connected to receiver, means a single antenna can be used for transmission and receiving purpose both. Single antenna can be used for transmission, or transmitter, or transmitting the signal and also receiving the signal. Port 2 is connected to port 3. In the same way, receiver is connected to the matching network, and matching network is again connected to another circuits in the radar. Matching network is again connected to another circuits in the radar system. Okay, so this is one of the application, practical application of circuit breakers. Now the next topic we are going to study is microwave sources and devices. We are going to study microwave sources and devices. Okay? And in microwave sources, we will study some of the devices or some of the amplifiers which is been used to amplify the microwave signals. We will see some of the diode. We will see gun diode, pin diode in next lectures. Okay. At some point in microwave, suppose you have point B over here. You may be having a low power. Okay, you may be having a low power of microwave signal. Then over here you need an amplifier to reach to point B or to amplify the signal. Now the first topic in microwave sources and devices which we are going to study is nothing but 2-cavity klystron amplifier. Remember, it's 2-cavity klystron amplifier. Okay, 2-cavity klystron amplifier. Remember, this is an amplifier. This is not a source of or generator of microwave signal. This is an amplifier. So we need to supply a low power of signal to this amplifier, and it will amplify the signal of, if this is the input, then this much will be the output with high power, and that is being given to point B. Okay, if this is an input, this will be the output, and it will be given to the ahead, another signal. Okay, it will be given to another signal. This is a small signal. This is a small signal. Okay, so we will see 2-cavity klystron amplifier. Now let us see what is the construction of 2-cavity klystron amplifier. Is, I have already taken a photograph from the reference book so that it will be more clear picture to understand. It will be more clear picture to understand small things very minutely. Okay, this is position of gap B, this is of A, remember this is of A and B. Okay, now we will see the 2-cavity klystron amplifier construction. First of all, we will see construction. As the name suggests that it is having two cavity, that is, one is the Bunsen cavity and another is Cantor cavity. Okay, these are the two cavities. One is the Bunsen cavity, this is the Bunsen cavity, and this is the catcher cavity. Okay, this is the catcher cavity. This is the catcher cavity. Okay, this is the first one. This is the second one. Okay, this is being used as RF input. You can see RF input, and this is being used for RF output. Now let us see, first of all, the basic construction is both the cavity, puncture cavity and catcher cavity, are being separated by a small space. Are being separated by a small space, which is being known as drift space. Okay? Both the cavities are being separated by a small space known as drift space. And we can also see that an arrangement of electron gun and anode. So this is a cathode. This is cathode. Okay. So over here you can see this is an arrangement of anode and cathode, and connected to this supply, and connected to this power supply. Okay. To this power supply. This is plus, this is minus. Okay. And connected to a power supply. Now what happens then? What happens when you connect this supply to electron gun and this supply to anode? What happens that to anode, this anode is been working as a collector. This will work as a collector. Okay? And this will work as an electron gun. This will work as electron gun. So it will have flow of electrons like this. It will have flow of electrons in this direction. Okay? In this direction. It will have flow of electrons in this direction. That is from electron gun to anode. Okay? That is from electron gun to anode. Now, we have an interesting case when we apply an RF input. Over here, we have an interesting case, okay, to study when we have an RF input. Remember one thing, very important point, this both two cavities are this cavity 1 and cavity 2, there is puncture and catcher cavity, that is first one is the input cavity and second is the output cavity, that is catcher cavity. Okay, both cavities are being designed with the resonance, maximum resonance between them. Designed with the maximum resonance between them. Now what happens when you have RF input inside this? What is going to happen is, if you have an RF input, then this kind of signal, this kind of AC signal is going to be present in between the gap A. This is gap A. Remember, this is gap A and this is gap B. Okay? You will have this kind of AC signal at gap A. Okay? Let us first discuss with respect to gap A. Right? You will have this kind of AC signal. Okay? This AC is nothing but, this is represented by this diagram. Okay, this has been represented by this diagram. This AC signal is being present in between this gap. Okay, in between this gap. Right? So let me clear out the picture. Okay, now this gap over here. When we have RF input, we will have AC signal. Okay? Passing through this gap A. AC signal passing through this gap A. And we also have flow of electrons in this direction. Okay? We have flow of electrons in this direction due to electron gun and anode. Due to this battery. You do this battery. Voltage, potential connected. Okay? Now what happens? What happens when this electron, when this DC electron, the flow of electron, when this beam of electron, when a beam of electron will have
interaction with the RF signal. What is going to happen when the beam of electron is going to have an interaction with the RF signal? That is been explained by this Apple gate diagram.
Okay. Let us understand what is Apple gate diagram. Okay. Now, remember, this is the voltage across gap A over here. This is the voltage across gap A. This is the position of gap A, means over here. This is the disposition, and this is the position at gap B. Okay, this is the position at gap B. So what is the position and condition of electrons? That will be explained by this. Okay, let us discuss this. This is very important. Okay, let us discuss this. Now, be careful. When an electron is interacting with this B point, let us have three different points, that is A dash, B dash and C dash. Okay, this B dash, then we will have A dash, and we will have C dash. Okay, we have three different points in this AC signal. We will have three different points. We are defining three different points, that is A dash, B dash, C dash. Okay.
Line is B, then let me use another color. This is A, and this is C. Okay.
Now what happens when an electron is passing through B? It is passing through, if we take an average of AC signal, it is having zero potential over there. So it is known as reference electron. So the velocity of electron V will be remain same. It is known as ER. That is the reference electrons, and the velocity through which the electron is traveling through this gap, will remain same. Why? Because the potential over here of the RF signal is zero. Over here it is positive, over here it is negative, but electron is passing through this point. Okay? Okay, so at this point, the potential of the AC RF signal, input AC RF signal, is zero. Okay, so it is being unaffected. So the velocity of the electron through which it is traveling, through which it is traveling from electron gun to anode, will remain same. That is why it is known as E reference. That is V is equals to V0. Okay? But now what happens when an electron is traveling at point C or at point A? Because this is going to change continuously. RF signal in gap A is going to change continuously. Okay? Now, you can imagine that B will have the same velocity, but when electron is interacting with this negative peak and positive peak, its velocity is being changed. When an electron is passing through the interaction of this negative side, this negative peak, when an electron is passing through this gap with the negative peak or positive peak, its velocity is going to change. And that is known as the velocity modulation. Okay? And you will also study the current modulation. That is also known as current modulation when it reaches to this point. That is this point.
this point, okay, this point, position at B, this point, okay.
Now what happens when it travels,
and interacts with this negative peak at position A, okay? If electron is interacting with this negative peak of RF input cycle, electron is traveling in this direction, and AC RF input signal is passing in this direction, in Bunsen cavity, because this is an input, okay? So this electron beam will have interaction with the AC cycle, with the AC signal, and we have considered three points A, B and C. At B, the electron will not have any kind of changes because that is the neutral point, that is zero potential. But at A and C, the velocity of electron through which it is traveling will vary, will change. That is known as velocity modulation. Now, what happens when an electron is interacting with this negative peak? When an electron is interacting with this negative peak, remember, as this is more negative, okay, negative will have repulsion, and this is negative potential, so it will deaccelerate the electron, okay, and the velocity V will be changed to less than V0. So this is known as early electron. Okay, so velocity will be reduced. So it will take a longer time to reach at this point, okay, due to negative potential. But the vice versa, in C, if electron is interacting with this positive peak, then the velocity will increase due to the plus potential, due to positive potential, positive field in this peak, and it will have V greater than V0. That is known as late electron. Now, all these three electrons will have a arrangement in such a way, that all three are going to meet at one particular point. Okay? Remember this, all three electrons will be velocity modulated in such a way that they are going to meet at point B, and that gap B is nothing but this point. Okay? This is the gap B. You can see this is the gap B. This is the gap B. Okay? This is the gap B. So all these three will meet at a particular point. Okay? And they will have a very high current. As they are bulky in electrons, they will have very high power. And as I told you initially, that these two cavities are kept at a resonance. Due to resonance, you will have an RF signal generated over here, and this bunch of electron will pass on the power to the AC signal. And AC signal will be amplified. This bunch of electron will pass on the power to the AC signal, which is being generated due to resonance, and we will have the increase in the power of RF signal, and output will be taken over here. Okay? Now remember, this space is known as drift space. These are electron bunches, square brackets that you are seeing, and the time travel by all three electrons will be different. This is for late, this is for reference, and this is for early electron. Okay? All three have different time. But remember, all three will meet at a particular place, at a
time, at an instant of time, at an instant of time, all three will be at a particular place. Okay? So, this was all about the two-cavity klystron amplifier. Okay? Thank you.